Last week on Clarksville Fat to Fit.
This week I think that I feel exhausted. I think I overexhausted myself to the best of my abilities. I gave everything I had, and yesterday I had to sleep for 21 hours to make up for it after vomiting a few times. Sorry, America, but it's true.
Yeah, so far, I mean, I've noticed my clothes are getting bigger. So, I mean, that means I'm doing something. And then this past week, I was tired, but at the same time, I was ready to go. And, like, the week went by quick.
Oh! Hi there! So, I didn't realize you were watching, but I guess now's as good a time as any. Hi guys, I'm David Shelton with Imagine Media Solutions, and I'm director and producer of Clarksville Fat to Fit. Now, I've sort of been looking around at some of the episodes that we've told, and we've had some great episodes. But let's be honest, we're not telling the stories that we need to tell. This is about our contestants and the people who are spending their 12 weeks of their lives to go from fat to fit. And starting tonight, I want to just say, lesson learned.
Tonight, drama at Potato Bowl.
Let he who is out sin cast the first stone on me.
And we visit the Clarksville Realtors Association fundraiser for Fuel Ministries. And the toughest workout yet with head trainer Ray Hula. It's all part of our quest to go from fat to fit. This week's conversation was rained out, so we stopped by to visit our friends at Potato Bowl to have a conversation over lunch, and yes, they were salads. It was a tough week for Mary Beth.
Yes, I've been moving and going to school and, you know, trying to do things on my own.
So, Mary Beth, you have had a little bit of a bad thing this week with the egg first pasta. Of course, I've had my share of bad things. So what do you think your appropriate penance should be for that? Since... Because you know that...
Let he who is without sin cast the first stone on me. Let he who is without sin cast the first stone on me.
And they will, trust me.
Really, the schedule had been not so much a frustration, but a challenge.
Mm-hmm.
Mainly
work nights, correct?
Yeah, and working nights as well, you know. Cause,
feeling pretty good. A little tired today. I think just my body's telling me rest tomorrow. But everything else is going pretty good.
Comments from people that don't even know I'm on the show, and then people that do know, and yeah, so it's good.
Now, this week's probably been the hardest week for me, I guess physically. I mean, I've tried to hit the gym pretty hard, just like Coach Shedd has.
I moved a whole apartment by myself with the help of my lovely friends. I went to yoga, I went to the gym. Mm-hmm. You know, moving is a lot of work. I think I'll be forgiven.
After the break,
I would cry and say, "No, Mom, you don't understand. You didn't live in Germany for 3 years."
I'm kind of lazy, I guess, you know. I need some accountability. So when I signed up for Title Boxing, that's what I got. Great workout. You feel so good afterward. You know, you got a ton of energy. Just hitting the bag feels good. They're going to tell you what to do. You're going to do it. You're going to be motivated. And you're going to feel really good for 1 hour.
Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Dale Brown. With me is my Maximize Living team. And we want you to know that it's our vision to see each and every one of you reach your full potential in health and life. And we believe that can be achieved through implementing the five essentials of maximized living. Number one, maximize your mindset. Number two, maximize nerve supply through a properly aligned spine. Number three, quality nutrition. Number four, lean muscle and oxygen. Number five, minimizing toxicity. So we want you to join the movement that is truly changing healthcare in America.
Say you don't have health insurance. Or maybe you do and the deductibles are too high. Any Lab Test Now's No Insurance, No Problem program is your solution. Any Lab Test Now offers you the health information you need at prices you can afford. No appointment or referral is necessary. You can test anonymously. Your results are confidential. And most are provided in 24 to 48 hours. No insurance, no problem. You can count on any Lab Test Now.
Is your house killing you? Let us buy your home. Is your house vacant? Need repairs? Bad tenant? Job transfer or relocation? Do you owe liens? Are you making two house payments? In foreclosure? Divorce? Owe taxes? Has your listing expired? Estate sale? We could buy your home in any area, any price, and in any condition. For more information on how we can help, go to ClarksvillePropertySolutions.com or call us today at 931-320-9707. A workout at Title Boxing Club is nothing to shake a stick at, but when Ray Hula leads a class, it's nothing short of brutal. One thing is for sure, this is not for the timid.
Getting compliments from people that don't even know I'm on the show, and then people that do know, and yeah, so it's good.
Come on! Ready, spring back.
I see all the bad habits, the emotional eating, everything that I used to. I'm not gonna say fast food because I've never been a fast food person per se, but like eating sweets all day long, I think of those things and what's got me here and those bad habits, the emotional eating, the eating in secret and privacy, and then, you know, I'd sit there and, you know, eat something and somebody would call me, oh, you want to go grab lunch? Sure, I haven't eaten yet. And I think of all that and, you know, I think, and I just want to kick myself in the butt. And it's, I think of eating from being bored, eating from being stressed, eating from all the different emotions, because I'm a very emotional eater. So that's what I think of when I'm thinking about. That's the bag, is everything that I've done to lead up to this point from a little girl. That's what the bag is to me. It's all those frustrations getting out.
I have managed to get in one of my workouts that I felt the best was that was coming off a 12-hour shift. Mm-hmm. I got off at 7 in the morning. I went to work out at 9:30 class, and I felt really good after that. And then I had to go home and go to bed and go to sleep to get up to work again. But
come on, pop, pop, pop! That's it, pop, pop, pop! Come on!
I was just the eater that kind of, like I heard Melissa say earlier, my friends would call and say, I'm hungry, you want to go to lunch? And I know I just ate, but I would go anyways and eat again. And I've always convinced myself that I didn't get as big as I was. I mean, I convinced myself that everybody around me was bigger, I was okay. And I even really remember once I moved back from Germany, and where I didn't have like the kind of lifestyle I have in America, where fast food is everywhere. When I got here from Germany, I remember my mom telling me, slow down, stop eating all that stuff. It's not going away. It's always going to be here. Stop trying to gorge yourself with cheeseburgers and fries and all this stuff that you haven't had for 3 years, because it's going to catch up. And I would cry and say, no, mom, you don't understand. You didn't live in Germany for 3 years. You didn't have to miss it. And now I look and I say, sadly, another one of the things my mom was right on. Mm-hmm.
10 seconds. Come on. 8 seconds. Keep going. I can still see you. There's mirrors over here. Come on. 3 seconds.
Feeling pretty good. Mm-hmm. A little tired today. Mm-hmm. I think just my body's telling me rest tomorrow. But everything else is going pretty good. Mm-hmm. Going well. Moved 2 notches on my belt since we started. That feels pretty good.
Yes.
Yeah, that feels pretty good. So,
come on, hurry, faster! Come on, go a little faster. Go a little faster than what you used to.
I tried to been going every day that I could. And so I think it took a toll on my body this week because I had a lot of ankle trouble come Thursday's workout. It was very hard doing the kickboxing with a sore ankle. But, I mean, I overcame it. I mean, today my ankle feels good and I'm ready to go tomorrow again, work out with my trainer, Michelle.
Come on, let's go. 5 seconds.
I see the bag as being bad things, maybe, mm-hmm. and being evil. Mm-hmm. I mean, sometimes when I really get the Waylon Array on that bag, I kind of envision myself fighting for my life, you know, and that's what drives me to just, you know, go all out on it. And mm-hmm. it could be a bad person or bad things for you or just bad and evil in general. Mm-hmm. And that's what, you know, it's almost like, you know, when I really go all out, when they tell us to go all out on the bag, I almost put myself in a life and death situation. And that's what drives me to keep pounding that thing, even though I'm totally whipped, you know. So.
And deep down, you feel when you get your salad delivered and your friends got their sandwich, fries, mashed potatoes, gravy, all that delivered on their plate, you deep down, you're really like, man, this salad does not look good, so good anymore.
That's a challenge.
Zombies with lame sandwiches? This is a job for Freedom Girl. There's only one weapon that can take out this kind of hunger. The smoking gun. It's boar's head buffalo chicken, hot cappy, melted cheese, chipotle mayo, lettuce, tomato, on pretzel bread. This sandwich will hit 'em where it counts. When you're that hungry, don't go for a sub. Reach for the smoking gun, only at Freedom Deli.
Freedom! Freedom!
Clarksville Fat to Fit is presented by Title Boxing Club, home of the Power Hour Workout, and Marathon Chiropractic, your maximized living center. And proudly sponsored by Any Lab Test Now, Potato Bowl, Freedom Deli, Clarksville Property Solutions, and Lee's Salon. After a great week of workouts and chiropractic, we had a chance to unwind and spend a little time with friends. Melissa is a real estate agent and invited the rest of us to spend a little time with friends and family at the Clarksville Association of Realtors to support the Fuel Ministry. It was all to support the kids of Montgomery County, many hundreds of whom do not get meals outside of their school meals.
How do you feel?
I feel amazing, especially after the ups and downs I've had the first few weeks, but this week I feel really good, especially after Thursday's workout.
So tell me about the workout, because that, I saw that workout, it was brutal.
It was. Ray is a beast. Ray is a beast. But it was an awesome workout. I mean, I think that's the most. I had a workout earlier in the day, a one-on-one with Gabe, and that almost lasted like, it was like an hour and 45 minutes or something, or an hour and a half, something like that. But my arms were already sore during that that workout that night. But
two workouts in one day.
Yeah,
That's pretty intense.
But, you know, afterwards, like, I was hurting during that, but I felt so amazing. And I felt great yesterday morning afterwards.
I feel great. This week was very hard. The workout, like everybody else has talked about, the warm-up killed me. But, I mean, I was able to make through it, though. Uh-huh. You know, I made it through it. I mean, now the rest of the workout I couldn't push as hard as I wanted to because I think I used all my energy in the warm-up, but... But it was good. Afterwards, I really felt it.
Grandma! now, have you heard about Factor Fit?
I have, actually. I didn't even watch the pilot episode.
Okay, you've watched it.
I did. It was great. I'm very excited.
So, do you know anybody on the show?
I maybe do. I may be going, Team Melissa!
Team Melissa. Yeah. Okay, so now, is this like a real estate thing?
Well, we do work together at Reliant Realty, so we're realtors together, but she's my dear, dear friend. So good, I'm totally supporting her and going, yeah, she's going to win.
I know it's been kind of rough, but we're sort of trudging along here. So how do you feel?
I'm tired, but I feel good. I feel good.
You've been working with Jen a little bit?
Yes. Jen and LaToya. Jen's 12-minute workout, never underestimate the power of a short workout.
You've heard of Factor Fit?
Yes.
All right, tell me about what you think of the show.
It was good.
Yeah.
You like it?
Yeah.
You like your friend Melissa on there?
Yeah, go Team Melissa.
Go Team Melissa.
Woo! 12-minute workout. So what do you do during this 12-minute workout?
She puts the clock on, and you do as many rounds of lifts as you can, and it's not for... It's not for the faint-hearted.
Uh-huh.
Faint-hearted, is that a word?
Yeah, that's a word.
Oh, okay.
It is now. So, yeah. One of the things you said early on is that you felt like you were letting the kid down because you weren't working as hard as you should. Mm-hmm. Now, what was it that actually drove you to come and consider being a part of the show?
Well, I saw on in the newspaper and on a couple of websites the opportunity was available. And I saw it as a way for me to, one, to get in better shape, but also as a way to put the accountability out front. Because again, you know, like I said from the beginning, I push kids, man. I push them hard because I can see greatness in them. But I also see in me the ability to get in better shape, the ability to be healthier and more fit. And I got to get there. And I just needed a little extra push, and I thought this might be able to help me.
So I know that you particularly had a lot going on these last couple of weeks.
Yes.
And so, I mean, if you had planned on doing all of those things, plus what we're doing now and that sort of thing, would you have told yourself, you know what, maybe this isn't the best time? Or what are your thought processes on that?
I think on the surface, I might have told myself it's not the right time because we tend to think sometimes just, oh, my kid.
We're taking a mommy break right about now.
Yes. Right, okay, so. As I was saying, on the surface, I probably would have told myself no, because when we tend to have so much going on, we like to think with a kind of a defeated attitude. Well, most of us, not all of us.
I mean, do you feel like that is working?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. I feel healthier. I feel stronger. Even in my younger years when I worked out a lot, I can think back on those days, and I don't think I was—I don't think I felt any better, even when I was younger, than I do right now. I think, you know, the whole Zija product has kicked in for me. I really don't feel a lot of—I have some pain still, you know, from my age, I guess. But I work right through them. I mean.
Say you don't have health insurance. Or maybe you do and the deductibles are too high. Any Lab Test Now's No Insurance, No Problem program is your solution. Any Lab Test Now offers you the health information you need at prices you can afford. No appointment or referral is necessary. You can test anonymously. Your results are confidential. And most are provided in 24 to 48 hours. No insurance, no problem. You can count on any Lab Test Now.
Kind of lazy, I guess. You know, I need some accountability. So when I signed up for Title Boxing, that's what I got. Great workout. You feel so good afterward. You know, you got a ton of energy. Just hitting the bag feels good. They're gonna tell you what to do. You're gonna do it. You're gonna be motivated, and you're gonna feel really good for 1 hour.
Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Dale Brown. With me is my Maximize Living team, and we want you to know that it's our vision to see each and every one of you reach your full potential in health and life. And we believe that can be achieved through implementing the five essentials of Maximize Living. Number one, maximize your mindset. Number two, maximize nerve supply through a properly aligned spine. Number three, quality nutrition. Number four, lean muscle and oxygen. Number five, minimizing toxicity. So we want you to join the movement that is truly changing healthcare in America.
Is your house killing you? Let us buy your home. Is your house vacant? Need repairs? Bad tenant? Job transfer or relocation? Do you owe liens? Are you making two house payments? In foreclosure? Divorce? Owe taxes? Has your listing expired? Estate sale? We could buy your home in any area, any price, and in any condition. For more information on how we can help, go to ClarksvillePropertySolutions.com or call us today at 931-320-9707. We talked with Denise Skidmore to learn more about Fuel.
Currently in the Clarkson-Montgomery County school system, we were feeding at the end of the school year 2,000 children every Friday.
2,000.
And we still have children on waiting lists. Yes, sir.
Wow. And everything I've heard about the ministry has been fantastic. You've got support from how many churches in town right now?
Right at 100 churches right now.
Mm-hmm. Wow, so good.
Fuel is a really good program. I know there's a lot of kids that the only meals they get are the ones at school every day. And so when they get home on the weekend, they could go 48 hours without a good meal. And so for them to be able to get food to take home, I think is a really, really, really good thing.
What led you to start this?
A God intervention. He pulled me aside and told me that I was the one that was going to do it for him, and I strongly tried to convince him that I was not the person.
Funny how that works.
Yeah, and he kept saying, no, really, I think you are, and I kept saying, nah, I really don't have the skills for this.
Arguing with an omniscient being doesn't necessarily work. So
no. Mm-mm.
I also think that the way that our teachers and our administrators sneak the food into their backpacks so that not a lot of other kids know what's going on, I think that kind of preserves some dignity for those kids.
I want to do anything I can to encourage people to support the Fuel Ministry. How can they get a hold of you? How can they send donations?
You can reach me at telephone number 931-624-3181, and our address is P.O. Box 31176, Clarksville, Tennessee 37040.
A special treat for Melissa's daughter was a chance to ride the pony.
It's a good pony.
It's a good pony.
Okay, so it's ready. Did you slide it up?
Hold on to the horn, okay?
Hold on, okay?
Did you?
She knows what to do, doesn't she?
She's all for it.
She's ready for that one.
Okay, well,
you really have to lead
Regan.
I just
put
a kid on.
Come on, Regan.
I actually started out power walking around my block. It's about 1.5 miles. And I really didn't think I would get to this point, but I can actually jog that whole 1.5 miles, and it's up some pretty steep hills. And my daughter, I'm taking care of her dog, and her dog is a good-sized dog that loves to walk on a leash and even run. helps me set the pace, so that's been kind of fun.
Well, I've coached over at Clarksville National Little League for several years now. My son has got an affinity for sports, and so we've coached over there for several years. We're in the middle of our tournament right now, and hopefully the Reds will get an opportunity to play for a championship in a couple days. And then the Clarksville Basketball League has come out of some work that a friend of mine and I have done, and we actually started this past fall and winter. That's the t-shirts that you've seen me wear. And that league is geared towards more advanced and developed players in about the middle school age.
Me and Shed have been battling back and forth on Facebook. He's been posting pictures of all the great food he's been eating.
And cooking.
And
for the record, Shed, you will invite us next time.
Yeah.
Right here, too.
He keeps tagging me in all these pictures of food, and I get on there thinking he's got a picture of me. And then I get on there, and all it is a picture of fish or a picture of chicken and vegetables. So, I mean, he needs to start inviting us to these dinners he's having.
I can just see it through her Facebook posts and talking to her. You know, she's so excited about taking the challenge and losing weight and getting in shape, and I think it's just good for all of us, because you know I'm not currently working out right now, and it's an inspiration, and it's hopefully that you know she's helping a lot of us, you know. And I hope you all five achieve your goals, and I hope more people like me, it inspires us to get into the gym and work out. I think it's great.
I see a lot of great progress. Everybody's doing great, you know, thanks to Title Club and everybody sticking their hands in there. I see so much stuff happening and so many improvements on everybody.
You got a preference as far as who you're cheering on the most?
What's that?
Who you're cheering on the most?
I like them all. I can't say that there's a favorite one, but I wish them all the best of luck.
So you're going to have to buy 5 t-shirts instead of one?
Probably so, and switch up every day.
Okay. Next week, BMI, a turning point. Everyone gets their week 4 weight figures. And Coach Shedd leads his baseball team to the championship match.
Let's go show that. All right, let's get the bats cracking. Let's go, guys. You got it. Nobody can hit with us.
Okay, so we can destroy the other one. All right, so now. All right, okay. Take 2. Now, so here we are.
Okay, take 2.
The obesity epidemic affects more and more people every day. The time for change is now.
Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Dale Brown. With me is my Maximize Living team, and we want you to know that it's our vision to see each and every one of you reach your full potential in health and life. And we believe that can be achieved through implementing the 5 essentials of Maximize Living. Number 1, maximize your mindset. Number 2, maximize nerve supply through a properly aligned spine. Number 3, quality nutrition. Number 4, lean muscle and oxygen. Number 5, minimizing toxicity. So we want you to join the movement that is truly changing healthcare in America.
I guess, you know, I need some accountability. So when I signed up for Title Boxing, that's what I got. Great workout. You feel so good afterward. You know, you got a ton of energy. Just hitting the bag feels good. They're going to tell you what to do. You're going to do it. You're going to be motivated. And you're going to feel really good for 1 hour.